Good, sir. You?
I can't complain. Kind of the reason I gave you a call was Crown Counsel, when they receive a private information that's laid at the court registry, it goes to Crown Counsel, and then Crown Counsel forward it to the jurisdiction kind of responsible for that area. And I guess they forwarded it to me because he laid an information, but there's no supporting documentation or anything that they could do a charge approval assessment on.
Right.
So I guess even with private informations, I looked it up in their policy manual, they need something to be able to kind of support any charge with in front of the court before it goes for first appearance.
Okay. And do you know, have they consulted with the regional Crown Director about a special prosecutor?
Well, I believe that it's gone through Crown Counsel to get information so that it can be put through the charge approval assessment to see if they require a special prosecutor, whether it's something that'll be in-house. Just seeing kind of the names involved here, I'd assume that once the information is collected, it would go to a special prosecutor, but I can't kind of confirm or deny anything on that.
Yeah, because there'd be a conflict of interest that applies to the named accused. And
yeah, obviously they're in the same office. So that's
yeah, so they'd
again,
have...
I'm just here to collect what information you'd have, send it to them, and then they would make any kind of assessments on whether they just offload the entire thing to a special prosecutor, whether they are able to make the charge approval assessment there. Kind of that's all in their kind of court. I've been asked to contact you just to get any of this information that you're able to hand over, or invite you in to come in for an interview, and then we can do it formally that way.
Okay. You said something about their policy?
Yeah, so they have obviously kind of with everybody's got specific policies, and they actually have, if you look it up, it's the Criminal Justice Branch, Ministry of Justice. There's a policy manual that you can find online.
Right.
So there's one specific to private prosecutions, dated June 20th, 2016. So that's kind of just on when it comes across my desk. Obviously, I want to be educated about it, so I looked it up myself, and obviously they have a bunch of steps they have to go through, and it's all on there as well. So,
okay.
I don't know if you want to look that up as well before you kind of make a decision on what you want to do.
I actually went over it like well over a year ago when I got assaulted by a police officer and tried to press assault charges. According to Crown Counsel, the laws apply to everyone.
Okay.
I found out the hard way it doesn't actually. So yeah, no, I know the policy you're talking about. I pretty much had it memorized well over a year ago. Probably still have it memorized today, but it seems to me like you're sort of out of order with their actual policy, and I'm wondering if this is an error or if they're trying to do some more funny business like they did a year ago.
I just have it sent to me. I look up at the policy. The policy said that they need, and kind of the communication from Crown is that if we could look into it and contact you about any supporting documentation that would be able to support that private information before it goes to charge approval. So that's what's been asked of me, and kind of from my reading of the policy, it seems in line with it. So, you know, you can decide to come in, or you can decide to send that documentation direct to the Crown Counsel and cut out the police.
Right, but you're aware that generally the branch policy doesn't permit private prosecutions in the province of British Columbia?
No, I'm not familiar with any.
That's actually the first sentence on their policy that you're talking about from June 20th, 2016?
Yeah, well, I see the top line there. The Crown Counsel will usually take conduct of the prosecution or direct to state proceedings after making a charge assessment, so once they have said information to support anything, then they will kind of make it the assessment of whether that private prosecution ends there, or basically there's a charge assessment and it goes through as a charge.
Right, but they're supposed to be impartial, are they not?
Well, I'm not going to kind of get into the questions. I've just asked you
right
if you want to come in for an interview or
Well, I'm just saying you're actually out of order with their policy, and I'm just wondering if this is done in error or this is something done on purpose.
What are you talking about out of order? I'm trying to figure out what you
Okay,
mean.
well, that, as the first sentence says on their policy, I just brought it up here in front of me because I had it saved. It says, generally, branch policy does not permit a private prosecution to proceed. Yeah. So generally means like usually, typically, what we normally do. So if they're impartial, then there's going to be something about this procedure that they've asked you to do that's either out of order or in error, or if there's something funny going on here. So let me just look here. Okay, so here it says, so I guess you could call it section one. It says Crown Counsel should A, review the private information and any other materials provided by the informant. So they can do that.
Got your information.
Yep, so they've reviewed it and there's no other materials provided, so they can't review that. So then B says review any existing investigatory materials prepared by the police or other investigative agencies relevant to the counts in the private information. So does any of that exist? Any previous?
Well, you haven't supplied anything with.
No, but I mean like when I brought this up in August 2016, that their criminal offenses that they were committing, was that ever investigated?
I don't know. I've just been asked to investigate your private information, so I
Okay.
don't know what happened in.
Okay. So I'm assuming because they held me in prison arbitrarily for 2 weeks that there are no existing materials that were investigated. So let's move on to C. See how we're doing here. Review any previous related legal actions, so they could have done that, and they can do that, or complaints, or other private information sworn, or attempted to be sworn by the informant. So they can do that, right? Crown Counsel can do that. They can review it all. It's all there. All right, so we're moving on to the last one here. D, where appropriate. Refer the information and other materials to the police or other investigative agency so they can decide whether to investigate and repair a report to Crown Counsel. So you can see here, obviously, this, because of the conflict of interest, it's not appropriate. Yeah, because they want to get all the information so they can say they reviewed it, they can stay the charge, send me the paperwork, say, have a nice day, we got off on criminal offenses because the laws don't apply to us. So that's not appropriate, right? Wouldn't you agree it's not appropriate that I send them all the information so they can review it and they can investigate it and they can say that this the charge standard doesn't apply? Because that's exactly what they did to me a little over a year ago when a police officer assaulted me. I got it on film. I got pictures of the mark that his flashlight left in my forehead. Plus, he admits on the film that he did assault me, and they say that that doesn't meet the charge approval standard, which is hilarious because just previous to that, I actually got prosecuted for the same criminal offense of assault when there actually was no evidence. But that met the charge standard. So you can see, according to their policy, section 1D, where it says where appropriate, this is not appropriate, sir. The
You don't want to.
connected agencies should not be investigating themselves. And you're a connected agency with Crown Counsel. Crown Counsel is a connected agency with the Victoria Police Department. So obviously, this is not appropriate.
So you don't want to come in for an interview or provide any of the documentation?
I absolutely could if it was done through an appropriate investigative agency. But the VicPD is that's not appropriate.
Which agency would you suggest then?
That's not up to me, sir.
So you don't want to come in for an interview or.
I absolutely would love to, but it's got to be with an appropriate investigative agency.
You don't know what agency you'd like to come in and talk to.
Is it up to me?
Well, I just asked for your opinion on it, and I
Okay.
So, do you have any suggestions in that matter?
I mean, it doesn't really matter to me. It would have to be an agency that is outside the jurisdiction of the City of Victoria. But the other thing too, just going by their policy here, unfortunately, what they're going to have to do is they're going to have to wait until after the process hearing to get anything. And if anyone wants anything from me, they're going to have to fill out and send me the appropriate paperwork, and I'll consider it and respond within 30 business days, because according to the criminal code, I'm supposed to be getting a process hearing. So I know they have a policy that generally they don't allow private prosecutions in the province of British Columbia, which is odd for an impartial agency to say that. But according to the criminal code, we're supposed to have a process hearing, and all the evidence that I have is actually supposed to go before a judge. There's nothing in the criminal code states that I have to hand it all over to the police or Crown Counsel, and I hope you understand there's good reason why it's not in there. So
Just here to ask you if you wanted for an interview. So if
once.
you want to, I will forward that off to Crown Counsel, and then they can kind of be in touch with you kind of the minute you were talking about. And
Yeah.
there you go.
Like I said, I've already been, this isn't my first rodeo with them, if you know what I'm
I
saying.
have another call coming here.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, have a good day.
All right.
Okay,
Bye.
bye-bye.